Alright, this is Geneforge, old RPG from spiderweb software. So, there's three main classes, the Shaper, the Guardian, the Agent. The Shaper has strong shaping skills, which are summoning skills, basically. Which means they can summon stronger creatures easier. Whenever you summon things, they get a level bonus based on your shaping skill. That's the main effect. Every level they get more health and attack damage and stuff. Every two levels, each creature gets a bonus to all their core stats. So shapers are strong shaping, weak combat. Melee is melee weapons. It just affects the damage and hit rate. Missile weapons, it's for things like javelins. I think there's a crossbow somewhere in the game. And then these weapons called batons, which are kind of like crossbows, only they're bio-organic, whatever the hell you want to call them. But then there's magic skills, which are just spells that do things. There's not a lot of spells, but there's like three battle spells, three mental spells, three blessing spells. Spellcraft, it's like an upgrade to battle magic, mental magic, and blessing magic, and healing craft all at once. Healing craft is under shaping for some reason. It makes sense lore-wise, but it could fit under magic easy, but it's healing spells. There's three spells for that, too. But spellcraft is like an upgrade in all of them for way more skill point efficiency, basically. Leadership is for conversation options. It gives you the option to get through some areas peacefully, get extra quests, skip quests altogether, things like that. They pop up in conversation. Mechanics is disarming traps, picking locks on doors, activating switches, interacting with things like that. It's a pretty important skill. There's also a spell that uses your mechanic stat and two times your mental stat to have the same effect as using the mechanic skill. Luck is it's an all-around thing. It gives you defense, hit chance. I forget what the other thing was. Dodge rate, I think. But it's very cheap to level up, and its effect is very small. And then there's a few events in the game that use your luck stat. Luck's not a really important stat, but it's really easy to level up. So there is that. Endurance affects your health. Intelligence gives you spell energy for casting spells. Essence, which is for casting spells and summoning creatures. It helps you resist some of those mental effects and stuff. Dexterity is dodging and hitting with missile weapons. And it gives you a higher turn order. Strength is damage in melee combat, increases how much weight you can carry, and then makes you resistant to stunning. Stunning is a debuff that makes you lose action points on your next turn. If you get stunned enough in one round, you basically lose your next turn. But usually it'll just drop your, unless you have haste or something, it'll drop your action points to the point where you can either attack or move, but not both. If you get stunned enough, you'll get to the point where all you can do is move a little bit or use an item maybe, but you won't be able to attack or anything. Endurance helps you resist poison as well. So that's the Shaper, strong shaping, weak combat. The Guardian is strong combat, weak magic. So they're really hard to build any kind of magic spells because all their things are expensive. You can really only focus on one of these before it'd be pointless to play as a Guardian and be easier to play as an Agent or a Shaper. They do have strong combat skills though, and you're probably going to mainly go with melee because you don't have enough raw essence to summon lots of things to help you do damage output. So if you can do missile in a defensive build, but if you don't do melee, it's going to be hard to do enough damage unless you pour a lot into fire shaping or magic shaping. Battle shaping, would be helpful for some tanky creatures. But the agent has strong magic, weak shaping, so you can really only focus on either. You can get a few points into either battle or magic shaping. Fire shaping costs more than a single level up, so it's really hard to even do fire shaping as an agent. But, oh, and their healing spells are going to suck because of that. But because of how cheap these are, you can upgrade all of these easily. And spellcraft, since it's an upgrade to everything and you get it a little cheaper, because that's what the strong and weak are, whether things are cost more or cost less. Since they get really easy spellcraft, you can easily put spellcraft and one of these magic skills every level, or some other stat like quick action anatomy or these right here every level, so you can easily buff magic. It'll be all your damage, you get all the bonuses from mental magic, blessing magic, healing magic. You can't upgrade healing magic directly though, which sucks. Well, you can, but it's expensive. But so the essence formula, it's like 2 times intelligence times level for the shaper, but it's only it's 1.5 times intelligence times level for the guardian agent, I believe. So guardian agent get like a significant hit to their essence, which means they can't summon as many things. It's not too bad for the agent, since most of the agent's essence goes into spells instead of summoning. But since the guardian also starts with lower intelligence, he's gonna have a problem summoning a lot of things. You can summon one or two easily, especially if you buff them. But whereas the shaper can summon a small army of creatures that are decently strong because of his raw skills, in order to make them strong with these guys, you're going to have to put a lot of essence into them. And then this guy has horrible magic, so you can only spec into one of these easily. 2 of them would be a stretch, but this is the one we're going to play as. It's the harder one to play. But I think I'll be able to get through that. The developers originally thought the agent was harder because they expected people to not even use shaping at all. They thought that whatever your weak category was, players wouldn't even use. Like, they thought these guys wouldn't use magic, and that these guys wouldn't use combat, which they don't use combat at all because it's so easy to build an army. But what people ended up finding out was that you can easily spec into one of these and then just use one of these for backup and use all your buffs and all your attacks to keep your soldiers going. But they found that this guy, magic's too expensive to reliably use. Battle magic's kind of a waste because it's mainly for dealing damage, which your combat skills are way more effective at doing, even if you only spec into missile weapon, which melee weapons can get bonuses from quick action and anatomy. Missile weapon doesn't. It's like its own little category. But even if you spec only into missile weapon, it's still way more efficient for damage than battle magic. So battle magic's completely useless as a guardian, except in a few certain situations. At least that's what I think. But mental magic has one of the most useful spells in the game, Unlock, which uses your mechanics and 2 times your mental magic score to unlock things, disarm traps, in a wide range too, so you can hit multiple things at once. Blessing magic, it either you use it or you don't. Some people love it. Some people don't worry about it too much. But they are very useful, like speed. If you use speed and have a high enough level of it, you can give you and all your minions like an extra attack around easily, which is a lot of damage output. But anyway, we're gonna go with the guardian. We have 15 points to spend. I'm gonna get endurance for some health, strength for some melee damage, well, and some carry weight, because that was a really low strength score carry weight wise. And then I'm going to take 2 points of leadership and 1 point of luck. that 1 point of luck doesn't do a whole lot for me stat-wise, but one's the minimum requirement for certain events to activate. I don't remember when the first luck check is, but I have an extra point left over, so I'm just getting that done. And then leadership will... Leadership is probably the thing you want the most early on, because there's a lot of early checks for leadership. I'm going to read the intro. So, the Shapers are the oldest, most respected, most secretive, and most powerful of the magic sects. They have the power to magically create life. The Shapers can make new life forms from nothing but raw materials and pure magic. They can mold this life to serve their purpose, be it lighthouse work or major warfare. The Shapers guard the secrets of their powers very closely. To learn their techniques without permission is the court of speedy death at the hands of a guardian in the day or an agent in the night. After years of work, study, and testing, you have finally been accepted into the Shapers. You will spend your life advancing their will and delving into their secrets and powers. However, none of those secrets have been shared with you yet. First, you must complete your apprenticeship. You must spend 5 years out in a Shaper colony on a remote island watching their work and aiding their research. That's pretty brutal, 5 years. After a brief welcoming ceremony and a last night's celebration, you don your traditional garments and board your craft to the remote islands. The journey is 2 weeks long. You travel on a living craft, a specially modified Drake, which will carry you through rough seas to your destination. After a week's journey, you pass close to a small chain of islands. You consult your chart and find that one of them is named Sushia. I think that's how you pronounce it. Sushia. I'm going to say Sukia. Sukia Island. It is marked on your chart as barred. Shapers declare places barred for a variety of reasons. Experiments gone wrong, dangerous accidents, valuable secrets. Whatever the reason, any outsider in a barred place is punished with instant death. Curious, you stand at the edge of your craft carefully watching Sukia Island, wondering what secrets lie there. Oh, give me a second. As you watch, you fail to notice the sailing ship dead ahead of you off the southeast coast of the island. I really don't want to read this anyway. Your craft goes crazy. There's a little battle. The Drake burns the ship. Sails. The ship kills your little living dragon boat thing. You sink. You swim to this barred island. And you're stuck there. Have fun with that. I'm going to leave that up there in case anyone wants to read that when they watch this. Actually, I can just pause the video. Hold on. I'm going to just skip that. I don't want to read that anymore. I don't like reading, sorry. Okay. Well, I don't like reading something I've read before, really. Da-da-da. You stagger off the dock, weakened to the point of collapse by a desperate swim. After a few minutes, you start looking around. South coast of the island is where you are, apparently. Since the place is barred, you don't know much about it. I'm just going to give you guys a spoiler alert. It's barred because of the Geneforge. It's the name of the game. It's kind of obvious. Islands are generally barred because of a failed experiment and the presence of horrible rogue creatures. Except for the lapping waves of the dock, it's quiet. If you're going to get devoured, it's not immediately soon. However, you're stranded here and weak. And the beach stretches off down the east. You should probably go that way. I'm just going to be summing these up. Nah. Okay, I'm going to move on. That scrolling speed's too fast. I'm used to playing in full screen, not windowed mode, so just give me a moment. Preferences, scrolling speed, normal. So this is the tutorial area. I already know all the controls. I've played through half the areas in the game, but it was about a third of the game content-wise, because the last half the areas are really big. Ooh, so it's a canister. Basically, it's something they developed on this island alongside the Geneforge. You touch it, it absorbs into your DNA, modifies your DNA, and gives you basically power or knowledge, or just changes your body structure to make you stronger. They have a... So this one increased Firebolt by 1, so if you go into abilities, you'll see Firebolt, Battle Magic is 1. I can't use it though, because I have no Battle Magic skill. Research this. We've basically, there's just the key in here. That's the only thing interesting. Oh, that is a cloak on the ground right there. You can actually see items on the ground in this game. Cloak, grab that. We're gonna equip that because that gives me armor. That is a shirt. Shirts are also armor. Very little, but it's better than nothing. So we got the key and we got the canister of Firebolt. Yeah. So that's just telling me I can fire Firebolt now. Although I really can't because I don't have any battle magic. Well, I think I can actually, because I think it's just gonna be counted as a 1 point of Firebolt effectiveness, which is like no damage whatsoever. The no hit chance on anything above level 1, really. Just some plants, nothing useful there. That's a shield. I don't need the shirt. I already have one, and it's not worth taking. So that's a lever, which unlocks this door right here. What's in here? Barracks, and it looks ruined. That's awesome. So welcoming and inviting. So javelins are a ranged weapon, dagger is a melee weapon. I'm going to equip the dagger so I can stab the shit out of everything I see. Nothing in the jar. We'll just keep going. What's down here? So this is basically an inn, and you're trying to figure out why there's stuff here, because usually barred islands are the result of a big disaster, but this place looks fairly preserved. It was barred 200 years ago, I think. Robe is a better armor device and cloak, so I'm gonna just drop that on the ground. Belt gives me some armor too, so we'll take that. And that door is locked. Let's see if we can find a switch for that. Usually anything. Ooh, hey. So basically, we're in a field of orcs. It's a type of cattle that the Shapers created. It's basically a cow. They have horns. They're very meaty. They're livestock, basically. So normally they're not hostile, but I can forcibly attack them. I hit this attack button right here. And murder it. And 75 experience. It's quite a bit. The reason it's so much is because they're higher level than me. Oh shit, it fought back. So I'm gonna just murder these, give them the experience. They're normally peaceful, but experience scales based on the level of the enemy and the level of you. So if you're a low level, like a level 1, even these really weak creatures give a lot of experience. So every level is 1000 EXP, whether you're level... So level 1 to level 2 is 1000 EXP, level 98 to level 99, I don't even think it goes that high, is also 1000 EXP. It's a linear scale, but you get reduced EXP the higher level you are to balance that out. So that's the combat, in combat button, by the way. So I'm gonna just since they're not hostile, I have to hit that attack button after every attack, and I can't attack myself, apparently. That's unfortunate. It's like my favorite thing to do. Murdered. And I'm taking damage. That's not a good thing. I'm gonna end combat real quick. I'm gonna hit F10. That's a quick save button. The game always freezes up when you try and open the menu or quick save or save or load real quick. But that's just what it does. It's an older game, so it's not that big a deal, really. It's not letting me murder that cow. I'm gonna murder this one instead. That cow's turn. So I get 3 AP of movement. So an attack costs 5 AP. However, if you don't have at least 5 AP remaining after you attack, you lose all the AP left you have. So see how I had 6? It used all 6 because I had less than 5 remaining after it attacked. So F, which is also the start combat and combat button. There's a building right here. We'll go in there. There's a door right there and a lever for the door. What's in here? Thorns. Thorns are ammunition for the baton weapons I was talking about earlier. Oh, hey, I love how trash is it. Damn, I haven't the same. So, those are crystals. They're a combat item. You activate them, select a target, and it shoots a ice spear spell at them. It does damage, and it's the closest thing to battle magic a guardian will be able to use effectively. Unless you play a really bad guardian. So, notice your health doesn't regenerate in this game, naturally. That's a, there's a, gonna be a healing pool in the next area, though, since I don't have a healing spell yet, so that'll all be fine. And how the hell do I open this door? Look at my map. Am I missing some things? Nothing there, nothing. I don't know. Okay, we'll move on to the next area. The next area will have the first actual enemy. It's the second part of the tutorial area. You want to see the world map here. There it is. This is the world map. So this area is green. This area is red. Green means it's been cleared. So once you have more locations on your map, like let's say there's a green area here, a red area here, and a green area here, you can. So if you're in an area right here, you can pass through a green area to go to other destinations, but you can't pass through a red area to go to other destinations without traveling through it manually. I'll show you that in a second. We're gonna go into this building right here. So this is a hall where they create things, the shaping hall. It basically just explains these two pools right here. The green one, when you get close to it, restores your health constantly. It's really annoying if you stay near it too long, it just spams it. The blue one restores essence, which is for creating things. This is a book right here. That just explains essence, which I'll do that for you guys in a moment. This one explains creations. I'll do that in a moment. So this canister gave me the Create Fiora skill. This canister gave me the Heal skill. Now, thankfully, the developers were not sadistic enough to take away or thankfully, they were nice enough. Oh no, hold on, I have shaping skills as a... See, as an agent, you don't start with any shaping skills, so you can't create anything off the bat. But they do... As an agent, they are nice enough to give you 1 point of healing, so you can use the basic heal spell. Which is good, because the developers aren't... So, how creations work is, you have this little button right here. Creation menu. You click your whatever creature you want. We only have a Fiora right now, and that's its base cost. So if I want to summon it, it'll cost me 8 essence. I only have 9 total. I'm not gonna worry about upgrading it right now. Ta-da! That's my little salamander thing. So you'll notice that the essence pool does not heal my essence. Whenever you have something summoned, it permanently takes it away from your max essence until you get rid of this creature or it dies. If you absorb the creature, you get half of the essence you spent on it back immediately. If it dies, you don't get any of that essence back immediately. So we're just gonna explore back here real quick. I don't think there's anything back here, but it should be. Those are javelins. I don't have a baton yet. I thought there was a baton in the last area. Oh well. There's 3 paths right here. 2 of them are dead ends. I'm gonna go down this one. I'm pretty sure this is a dead end path. We're just gonna check this real quick because I think there's a little event down here. I don't remember everything, but yeah, there's a little event down here. Oh, yep, dead shaper apparently. Tunic, robe, dagger, healing spores. I'll take the dagger, I can probably sell it later. We're just gonna go down this way. Oh, this thing just explained to you the basic combat strategy for each of the 3 basic classes, because there's gonna be some rogue creations up ahead. And so there's a Fiora up ahead, it's clearly a rogue. Yeah, and it looks aggressive. I'm just gonna... Wait, can I cast Firebolt? Nope, I cannot cast Firebolt because I do not have magic spell. Battle magic skill. So the Fioras are ranged like that. You saw mine. I'm gonna stab that. 2 damage. The shit, Charmander, that's horrible. I'm gonna stab him. Yep, that's combat. How much EXP do I have? So between the 888. You do get reduced EXP for every creation you have out. Since I have 1, I get like 90% of total EXP. And then notice that's level 2. That's because it's 1 point from my fire shaping, 1 point from the knowledge of the skill, and its base level is 0. So it summons at level 2. If I go in here, you'll notice that it earns EXP as well. So when creations level up, they get skill points. It's a really stupid system, honestly. So it still costs essence to upgrade them. Like, see all these upgrades? Every point is 1 point to those core stats. You can spend the skill points they have to upgrade them after you summon them. If you don't have skill points, you can't upgrade them post-summon, but if you really need to upgrade them, you can just absorb them, go back to town to get your essence back, and then resummon them with better stats. It's kind of silly. Like, if you actually level your creature up a lot, you're not getting that much benefit out of it. Unless you somehow have it never die and you keep it around forever and it levels up a whole bunch and gets bonus stats off of it, I don't see how it would ever be useful. I'm gonna try using these. Oh, nope, I'm out of range. I'm gonna just hit end turn because I can't do anything. Oh, hey, Charmander's doing something. And Charmander killed it. Alright. Oh, actually. Okay, we're just gonna have him named Charmander. Tells you how to do combat, basically. I'm gonna go see if there's anything interesting in here. Oh, that's interesting. So every time you level up, you get 6 skill points to spend. Yep, 6. Every single level. That's why upgrading magic is a pain, and upgrading combat is easier than anything you can possibly do in this game. As a guardian, at least. So, how much health? Wow, 31 health. That's more than I had at level 10 as a shaper. Whew, that'll be helpful. Although, Guardians, Shapers, and Agents all have different formulas for their health, essence, and spell energy. Agents have the highest spell energy, Guardians have the highest health, Shapers have the highest essence. Guardians have the shittiest spell energy ever. It's basically directly related to which is weak and strong for these skills. So, gives you a chance. Very dangerous at high levels, I'm sure it is. I'm gonna do my leadership and mechanics early, because I personally think those are some of the most useful things to do early on. Combat's not too hard yet, so I don't really need a whole lot of damage or a whole lot of bonus actions every round from quick action, which is fucking OP. I wonder if you can max it out to 100% chance. That would be pretty bitchin'. Oh, you just look too far away from me, damn it. So I do know that I'm going to spec into one type of magic. I don't know which type though. I think storage warehouse. Okay, so this was the dialogue about batons. Basically, it's a bioengineered weapon. It just fires thorns out like a crossbow. And unlike javelins, the weapon doesn't get consumed, but the ammo does. Whereas javelins, the weapon is the ammo. We're probably just gonna summarize most of the dialogues. I really don't want to read them out loud. I need more armor. I'm just skipping my turn. I'm gonna see how this fight plays out. And Charmander is victorious. So, right. My essence went up, my health went up when I leveled, but my essence has gone up enough that I now have 4 when Charmander is out, which means I can use my healing spell. It costs 2 essence to use. I'm going to just heal us real quick. It uses all of my spell energy, apparently, which that's okay, because spell energy regenerates very fast and constantly. In combat, it regenerates on a turn-by-turn basis, so some spells will drain it out really fast. Shapers and agents can use that basic fireball attack spell endlessly without running out, though, because it doesn't use as much as the regeneration is. This is the quarantine waiting hall. So it's basically an area where it's kind of like customs. They check you in before they let you go through. And there's a servant mine here. Servant mines, they're a creature that are grown to be a very specific spot. They don't move, but the shapers have them just, they're like computers. They do the job a computer would do. Only they're a living creature. When you get towards it, it starts rousing itself. It gets very excited. You approach it. Its eyes are happy, basically. I think, I don't know, I'm not really reading that. Its name is Tavit, and it's asking me if I want to. Yes. What happened to this island? I'm limited in my scope of knowledge. So he doesn't know why the island is barred. How long were you abandoned? He doesn't know. He's been in hibernation. He knows that it was definitely more than a century. Last I checked, this island was abandoned 200 years ago. Spoiler right there, but if you're watching, you probably don't care. I'm the first person who has been here since the island was abandoned. Doesn't know what, it's just a research island, doesn't really know what it was about. What do I have to do to pass through the quarantine? Are you alright? I'm functioning properly. I'm functioning properly. Basically, it doesn't have a lot of sentient thought, it just does what it's supposed to. Let me pass. Scans me, basically. And he's like, yep, you're good. You can go in. And that's all I need from him. Exhausted that. We'll go this way. There's a door here. Ooh, so we come outside and we see a bunch of orcs. They're being watched over by a servile. Serviles, they're basically slaves that we create, and they're very obedient. They do things that we want them to. They're smart enough to work hard and work efficiently. Yeah, they're basically slaves. Well, they were slaves. Considering this island abandoned, they're kind of on their own now. Anyway. So, you see the servile, you're thinking that they're not, that the island isn't that horrible if their servile's still alive on it, after however how long it's been barred, 200 years, I think. You emerge, and the servile is very surprised. He's looking at you like, what the hell is going on? He's wondering where you come from. He runs over to speak with you, and you're gonna see him, he's just gonna move automatically towards me. Oh, hey, his name is Timo. So, alright, let's see. Let's read through this. He comes up to you, starts looking at you, starts wondering what you're doing. He's very surprised. He's not, like, super hyper-obedient like you thought a servile would be, because the other serviles you've seen before you were part of the shapers, I'm guessing. And he's like, what? He's looking at you and he's like, oh my, you're a shaper. I'm not crazy. You're definitely a shaper. He's saying hello. He's talking about a town called Vakri. Vakri. Tell me about Vakri. It's a village to the east, not very far. How can I get off? He doesn't really know, but he says go to Vakri and talk to the elder. He's talking about serviles as people, which you find odd. Hold on, I gotta... there are no other shapers here. He doesn't think so. He says you're a shaper. This is a little... So if it's in parentheses, it's... from the developers. Usually they're telling you that since You might not be the Shaper class, but agents and guardians and Shapers are all referred to as Shapers by people outside the Shapers. They put that there just so you're not sitting here going around as... Honestly, I think they put that there just so they didn't have to have three sets of dialogue for every single mention of the word Shaper to change it to guardian or agent. So you'll see I have two choices here. There are these choices change what your character thinks about serviles. There's the freedom and the servant thing. Really, one is you believe that creation should serve the Shapers. The other is you think they should be equal or free or something. Essentially, if you want to join the other sects, you gotta. Or the little factions. It's kind of like a political thing the serviles got going on. There's one that you have to advocate freedom enough times to be able to join. One you gotta advocate that they should be servants enough times to be able to join. And then there's another one that also has to be advocated for freedom, but they're a little more violent. The two, like one of the freedom ones believe that they should be equal with the Shapers, and they believe in working with the Shapers, trading with the Shapers, things like that. The other freedom sect don't believe that the Shapers will ever grant them freedom, and they're willing to take it by force even if it means they all die. Whereas the one that wants to be equal with Shapers, they're only going to fight if they don't have any other choice. Whereas so the other ones, they're like, we're not even going to try and reason with the Shapers, we're just going to murder them and take our freedom by force. So, yeah. If you join the violent ones, it makes the game a lot easier because you can just walk right through a lot of difficult areas without trouble, because they're allied with the people that usually give you trouble. And you get a little token from them that just basically lets you walk right through all the hard encounters of the game. Yeah, it's pretty OP. We're not going to join that one. We're going to do the freedom one, because we're going to join the first freedom branch in this playthrough. They're called the Awakened. We're glad to help you. Got the question. Do you know when this item was abandoned? I don't know. Okay, he's just telling you to go to the little town. So I'm not gonna murder these Orcs because they're not gonna give me EXP anymore. I think Orcs stopped giving me EXP at level 5, but this level will probably give me 30. Next level will give me like 5, and the level after that they won't give me anything. Or I think they'll give me 1 EXP. A glorious 1. But yeah, so see how these areas are green now? I can go, well, I'll show you another one because that's still connected to that area. Oh, wow, that was an unfortunate click. That was the introduction dialogue to this town. Basically, you come in and you see the, you see the serviles working that field right in front of me. You see them walking around. They notice you. Some of them are freaking out. Some of them are like, oh, what's that? Because they've never really dealt with a Shaper after developing their little equality belief system. So, yeah. They're wondering what the deal with you is. If I hold tab, this one has a unique name, so I'm going to talk to her. Servile woman looks at if you interest. So she's part of the Awaken branch, and she's welcoming you here. You all live here, you speak very well. Who does not speak well? Okay. Tell me more about the Awaken. So she's talking about the Awaken. It's basically a political branch led by a guy named Elra, I think that's how you pronounce it. Elra, who believe that servile should stand up for themselves and look to shapers as equals. They know that shapers wouldn't be too happy about that, but they want to work for equality. And what is your job? So she looks after serviles here in this little town. She's basically here to make sure they don't all become obedient little shaper people by turning to their old ways. She thinks there's a spy, a taker spy. Takers are the other branch I mentioned that are very violent and want to take their, they just want to be, what's the word I'm looking for? Hold on. They want to be above the shapers, basically. They want to take... I already explained this, I'm not explaining it again. I'm bad with words sometimes. Another question. That's all I can do with her. So I'm not going to search these chests because the things in there are owned. And if I take them, I get in trouble for stealing. If you get in trouble for committing crime, like stealing, murder, or slaughtering livestock too many times, the entire faction turns completely hostile. And when that happens, you lose... Well, first, they're all going to attack you on sight, and you lose the ability to do any quest they have. What do you survivors eat? I'm hungry. This is just food you can buy, but those prices are expensive here. There's a quest you can do from this guy, though. So he wants his knife back. He thinks it's been stolen, but it's disappeared, but he's not sure if it's been stolen or not. I'm gonna talk to this guy. This one just looks at you. He doesn't like fear you like some of the other ones do. He's like, welcome to our home. I am Leader Kobar. He's part of the Awakened and the leader of this village. So when he said leader, he was emphasizing it. And when he said it's a pleasure to have the shapers again, he wasn't too enthusiastic about it. Tell me more of your village. After the shapers abandoned us, we struggled to survive. We formed three villages that he knows of. What are the other two? To the east is Pentel, they're a servile lot. Past Pentel is Kozg. So Pentel is where the sect that I haven't talked about or introduced to you yet, and then Kozg is where the takers are. They hate you, and even more, they're terrified of you. The north is a wasteland. Northeast are mountains. So tell me of the Awakened. So he's just telling me what the Awakened, they want to be equal with the Shapers. I'm going to give them the freedom bonus. Learn more of the island and why it was abandoned. He doesn't know. He's just worried about the now and the future, not the past. Tells me to talk to this scholar, basically. Sorry about that. Let's see. What dangers do you face? Hunger, cold, rogue creations. We can plan and we can trade. Basically, he's telling me... Okay, yeah, we'll trade with him.
He's basically telling me that he wants my help and he'll help me.
We think there's something creating them in the area to the east of here. It's a little forest called Watch Hill. What can I find a boat? I'd help you, but we need your help first, blah blah blah. I was stranded here because a large ship destroyed my craft. I don't know who would do that. I can't believe anyone would attack a shaper in an open and foolish way. Only someone mad would do that to attract their wrath.
He wishes he could help me. And he doesn't think that even the takers, which are bent on destroying shapers, would have done that so openly. That's all the dialogue options I have for him right now. I got a quest from him, though, so we can go and do that here in a moment. That'll be a fun quest with lots of combat. Brodus Blade. Basically in charge of the guards here. In charge of the guards, basically. What sort of flats? There's bandits. I can help you with the bandits. He's happy that I want to help. Show me the bandits are to the north. They don't usually kill, but they take the food away from them. If we end their raids, he doesn't care if I kill them or if I just talk them out of fighting, out of the way. He said that you're awakened, tell me about it. I should not, I believe with all my heart, but that I'm not a good teacher. Okay. So you'll notice these ones have generic names, so they don't do anything for me. They're generic name NPCs. Just better to call them civilians, really. Useless NPCs. This person's so this is Leitz. Hello. Basically, she just looks at you. She's watching over the orcs here, and she says hello. Are you in charge of the orcs? Yes, they keep me back here so I don't play too close to where the monsters are, and they have me watch the orcs so I don't get bored. Aren't the orcs dangerous? She whacks it with a stick and is like, nah, they're fine. Do you know what I am? I'm guessing this is a child because she doesn't know what the shapers are. I'm a shaper we see and know everything. So this option is saying I'm looking for a stolen knife. I don't think it was stolen. I think it was just lost. I'll probably find it on the ground any minute now. And you look away. You turn around and there's a steel knife on the ground. And she's just like, yeah, I'm just go back to treat my orcs. So my quest is to turn that in, but I'm going to use that for a little bit, because that's stronger than what I have, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, 4 to 28 damage as opposed to 2 to 14. That dagger's classified as a sword. It's a pretty tiny sword. I'm gonna go this way. That's another unique NPC. He speaks crazy. I clack it, I glad to see you, me no thing. I smart like them, I know dumb, I know talk shape, I know talk like you, I talk servile, choice. Interesting. So essentially you just ask him what the serviles think of you, what does he know about you, and then ask him if you can ask him more questions. So where can I find a boat? He says, talk to leader Kobar while he's out on par. Talk to learned Pinner. And then who attacked my craft? He says, someone from the outside of the aisle. Cool. He's useless. I'll take that money because no one can see me back here. I don't want that. That's not helpful. And yeah, that's not helpful. Me and Charmander. Gotta find some good stuff. See, now if I was a shaper, I'd have two Charmanders right now. There's a trap right here. It's glorious.
I'm gonna hit F10 real quick. I don't know what kind of trap it is. It may kill me, it may not.
So we're just gonna save real fast. Yeah, quick save. This is a little buggy, like that. It explodes. Does not do a lot of damage, though. We're good. A bronze sword. That was worth it.
How much damage? 3 to 21 opposed to 4 to 20. Steel dagger's better. I'll use the steel dagger until I find something else, and then we'll just complete that quest. By turning it in. Oh, that'll be fine. That'll be fine. Whoops. Apparently he saw me. What sorts of things do you know? That's okay. I don't steal things that often, so we'll be fine. I just wanted the money. Money's good early on. This is a merchant.
You look at him, and he looks greedy and cunning, just like merchants are in the real world. All they want is your money. All this guy wants is my money. But I'm going to walk away with his money, because that's how trading works in this game. I would like to trade with you. Javelins, steals, ooh, chit and armor. I'm gonna get some chit and armor. I'm gonna sell that dagger, that baton, that dagger, that ammo. Those javelins. Yeah, that's good. I forgot to equip those boots. Hold on. I want those boots. I want that chitin armor. I don't want that. 7 armor. It's better than whatever the hell that shirt gave me. Let's see. In the absence of shapers, we had to fend for ourselves. So basically, they became farmers and merchants, and he just sells things that the shapers made before they left. Traded with other settlements. He had contacts in Pentel and Kaz, but since the rogues have come around, he's a lost contact. Oh, sorry. He's lost contact with them. So this just gave me a quest to find the merchant Pixley and the merchant Arth in Pentel and Kaz, and see if I could reestablish the trade routes. So yeah. There's another quest somewhere up here. What's this? I don't have enough mechanics. And I don't have any living tools yet either. Damn it. Well, I can't get into those yet. I'll get those later when I have a higher mechanic skill. Servile. Okay, this is. Nope. It's over here. So this is a little hidden house right over here. Chit and armor, thorn baton, thorns, gemstone. All things I can sell after we get rid of this guy.
Welcome, Shaper. I have Nob. I have been waiting for you to come see me. What are you doing back here, boy? He's been waiting here. He's making a big ol' risk because he is from the Takers. He is a spy. Hey, that woman down the main hall gave me a quest to find this guy, right? Yeah, we found the spy. And he wants me... Tell me about the Takers. Awaken on the right track, but they don't think there's any hope of true freedom until we get rid of Shapers, basically. He'll accept our support, but they want to leave the Shapers behind and be their own people. Who are your allies? I'm forbidden to say. Join us. I have another question. What sort of help do you want? East of here, you can find the leader of the Awakened. He wants me to kill him, and then the Takers will accept me with open hands. And if he dies, says don't return here, they'd all be angry as hell. Go east to Kaz, and they'll welcome you, and we'll help you contact our allies with incredible power.
Huh, they have allies? Where'd they get those? This is an empty island. Da 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 da. Well, I don't like the sound of these Takers, so I'm just gonna go tell them about the spy. The interesting thing is the spy did say that if we kill Elbra, even if Nob dies or disappears or whatever,
the Takers will still accept us with open arms since we killed Elra. So, yeah, that's a pretty good deal right there. I can just turn them in. If I want to join the Takers later, I can just do that easy. I'm not going to, though. I don't want to join them. Who are you? I found the spy. $240 experience. That's a good deal of EXP. That's 24% of a level. How close am I to level 3? 1611, that's not bad. And let's go back to Nob's house, because he has some good shit in there that I want to steal. And yes, that is my motivation for turning him in, stealing his shit.
We're killing him if he's still here. I might kill him if he hasn't left.
I wonder how much GXP he gives, to be honest. Oh well, we're about to find out. And he's gone. And took all his shit with him. Oh, nope. Just looked like he took all his shit with him. I get to steal all his shit anyway. And we're gonna turn around and sell it to the merchant. That's glorious. Glorious. Is that a chainmail shirt on the ground? I should get that later. I'm gonna sell the baton, sell the chitin armor, sell the gemstone. There's a chainmail shirt on the ground. Yeah, that's a chainmail vest. Chitin armor 7. 12. Minus 1 to attack skills. I think attack skills means melee weapons, missile weapons. And. Yeah, I think it just means melee and missile weapons. Not really worth stealing right now. Because those skills are kind of fairly low, and I need those for my hit chance. Well, I need melee weapons, I don't really need missile weapons.
Let's go up here. Someone told me about a
scholar type dude that's up here. Called Learn Piner. I forget who told me. I think it was a leader who told me. Oh, it was the leader and that other guy that didn't want to tell me about their beliefs.
He's an old servile. Oldest you've ever seen, and they were made to live for a really long time. Wow.
She must be well over 100 years old. She sees you. She has great exert to keep effort.
I just read that completely wrong. Whatever. Exert great effort to keep from breaking down, overwhelmed with emotions, stares at you with awe. As if
so basically she's looking at me like I'm some kind of god. Cool.
Says welcome, tells me your name, what do you have to learn before your name, mass, mark of respect. Why is it either barb, you don't know. You left 2 centuries, 200 years ago.
Did not tell us why. I know where you might look, though. There's a ruin to the north of here. That place would have had a servant mine, and that mine would have been told more of why it was abandoned. Go there and see if you can learn anything. Be careful, there are little creations in there.
Okay.
So, you got another quest. I like quests. Why is everyone in awe? Because you're one of our creators, and you disappeared, and now you're back. And you could probably kill us all. Heh, I ain't that strong yet, but I will be. Well, for yourselves, that's the freedom choice again. I found some very strange artifacts. Canisters. They were created by the Shapers. What are they for? They made them on this island. We can't use them because it kills us instantly.
So canisters don't work on anything other than humans, apparently. Creations it doesn't work on. Okay. She says nothing unusual looks... Nothing looks unusual about me from the use of those canisters, but if I use more of them, I can get examined again. She wants to see if I change. If I recall correctly, they do change you after you use a lot of them, but you have to use like 20 of them. But you want to use all of them, because that's the only way to increase your skills in the first game. In the second game, you can buy skills from merchant or, well, from trainers. You can also get some skills as reward from quests, and I think there's one guy that can sell training and some skills in this game, but I don't know. I've only played through half the areas, about a third of the game, before I started this playthrough, so we'll see. Strange artifact, no. I need a boat. Talk to the leader, so all you did was give me a quest. What's it here? Nothing. Also nothing. No canisters to use. You always want to use canisters. Canisters are the best things ever. What's over here? A book. That's the exact same dialogue. I'll take that. Lol. Song is from way far away. Okay. So, I think I've exhausted all my stuff to do in here for right now. So let's go get started on those quests. Da 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 da. Walking takes a while. When you walk all the way across the map. And there's nothing to stop you from walking. Alright, so blue zone's the exit. I'm going to hit the menu right here. I'm going to use Guardian 1, that's going to be the name of the save. Alright, game is saved, and I'm going to end the first video here. Click.